just have the can, I mean, the frozen chopped spinach. Two 10-ounce boxes. Thaw them and break them up, you know, just put them in a container in a bowl and mash up two bricks of tofu, or excuse me, 1.5 bricks of that firm tofu. And then you'll have 3 cups. 1 brick is 2 cups. And so you just mash that up and then add the seasonings here. 1 small diced onion, or you can use that dried onion if you like. And Italian seasoning, garlic, salt, basil, and that imitation chicken seasoning. And if you don't have the chicken seasoning, you can just use a little extra salt. Weak there. And I don't cook my noodles first, because this is faster. And it just saves that step. You know, I used to boil the lasagna noodles first. And then someone showed me doing this, and I've been doing it this way ever since. It just cooks really, really great just in the casserole itself. And these are just the white durum wheat lasagna noodles. I like to use the whole wheat, actually, for myself. That sometimes for people and for your family maybe that aren't used to this kind of cooking, you might start using just the regular ones. And in this size pan, they just fit right in there. It's so easy. And then maybe a little more sauce on top of those. And just layer this in there. I'll probably do 3 layers of noodles and then 2 layers of filling. So I'll put about half of this in there. Sweets. I mean, we really don't usually eat ice cream 2-3 times a day at home, and all these fancy things that we're doing for you. I mean, I don't want you to get the idea that this is the way you have to go home and eat. But we're trying to fit everything in and give you a taste of everything that we can here. And then you should go home and spread it out a little bit. So this is the very same idea. Just crackers and pie crust are very similar types of pastry. Just like you would shortening into the flour. This is the very same idea. And then you add the water.
Okay, Rilla, tell us what the food's about.
Well, this morning we're at Rosario Beach, and this is our final breakfast. And we're serving a nice variety of whole grains and fixed in various ways, and some fresh fruit. Our crepes this morning are made from whole wheat flour. And for toppings, we have three separate toppings. Hot applesauce, and people can use peanut butter with the hot applesauce. We have a strawberry topping and a blueberry topping. And then there's millet butter and orange juice and cereals and a whole array of fresh fruit, apples and grapes and bananas and a fruit salad. And to encourage people to eat apples, we actually slice some for them, because we're trying to get them to eat more apples.
And who gets to eat all this good food here this morning? Oh, these are they. Anybody hungry this morning?
Yes.
Anybody starving? I mean, are they starving you here?
No.
Okay. All right.
Understand what's happening. And I found something on the plain old apple. You know, apple is so common. You can buy apples anywhere, any time of the year. And so I just wanted you to know a little bit more about the plain old apple. It says a plain old apple contains 191 known chemical compounds, each of which plays an important part in human nutrition. When you eat that apple, 1,300 chemical reactions occur to break it down into its various molecules for utilization. The pectin, for example, goes to the large intestine. The vitamin C is sent to the skin. The vitamin A goes to the retina of the eye, and so on, for 191 times. You don't make it happen, because you don't even know it's happening. There are 160,000 edible plants on our globe that provide nutrition. Anyway, it goes on and says that a God who knows much more than we do has asked us to please take care of our bodies and to put in them. It's interesting, it's not in this article, but I saw an article that said that if you were to look at an analysis of the one cell of an apple and then transmit it to the cell of the human body, you would find that what's in the apple is exactly what every human cell needs. So we have lots of fresh apples this morning. And we want you to know that this is one of the best things you could do for yourself. At home, I eat at least two apples, maybe three apples a day. And that old saying, an apple a day keeps the
doctor away.
It's true. It's true. It's very true. It's not just the saying. So have an apple this morning.
One second, I'll be done.
Layer burrito and asked him to leave off the cheese and the sour cream if you want. And it's delicious.
We are.
And if you'd all say crepes together.
Grapes.
Grapes. Grapes.
Grapes.
All right.
Oh, grapes. Grapes. Grape place. Love it.
How many of you promise you'll never do it again? Let me see your hands. All right.